Good afternoon, class. Today's lecture will be on meandering rivers. Have you ever wondered why some rivers meander? Here are a couple pictures to give you a general idea of what a meandering river looks like. I will start by defining two important terms to help you understand this process: cut bank and point bar. Cut banks are on the outside of a river channel. They are continually undergoing erosion. They are the deepest and steepest part of a river because here the current is moving fast. Point bars are on the inside of a river channel. They are continually undergoing deposition. They are shallow and have a gentle slope because here the current is moving slow. As sediment moves down a river, it follows a natural curve. Some sediment sweeps out of the curve and slams into the other side. After enough time, the sediment erodes away the bank, creating cut banks. This line represents the slower current in a river. As the slower current moves through the river, it drops some of its sediment load. The sediment continues to fall and accumulate, creating point bars. These forces working together create a meandering river. Over time, the meander becomes more and more extreme. And here are a few more pictures. A meander can become so extreme, the two loops can connect, and the river will take the most direct path downstream. When this happens, we get an oxbow lake, and many can form here, and 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 many others. Here is a photo of the scars left behind by a river in Argentina that has meandered for a long period of time, carving up the landscape. There are many more features left behind by a meandering river that we will cover in the next lecture. I hope today's lecture has been enlightening, and if you want to know more about meandering rivers, there is a geomorphology class offered in the fall here on campus. Thank you, and have a great day. Created using Powtoon.